high notes for a trombone player. You know, how many, I have to ask you a question. How many of you as kids or adults have played or do play a musical instrument? I would say a high percentage. Of course, I can't see any of you. Maybe that's a good thing, I don't know. Anyway, the reason I ask is because jazz seems to not be enjoyed by the average public. It's enjoyed by those that have had some sort of musical background, as is classical music. And when I was a kid, I was forced to play any instrument I wanted to, and it was a saxophone. I chose because I heard Freddie Martin when he was sober. So that's how I got started. And I started to hear jazz, but I thought, wait, I just heard the melody, but I haven't heard it now for 22 minutes. They've been soloing, and I don't know what they're playing. And then I heard the Dave Pell Octet. And then I heard George Shearing. And then I heard Art Pepper in his 11. And then I heard Marty Page's Tec-Tet. And they had solos, but they didn't go on forever. And that, how would you like to be in my shoes and get to play the music that you grew up playing? You get to play it with the very best players around. Somebody up there likes me, I'll tell you that. So with that, why don't we play a little George Shearing?
Thank you. Thank you. What's the name of that tune? What a crowd. We didn't even have to play it then. Thank you. This is the first time the Sextet has appeared in this My name is Kenny Dorham. Ever heard of me? KD. What was his nickname? Stumped this crowd, finally, man. I got him, a jazz crowd. Kenny Dorham's nickname was the Uncrowned King. They called him the Uncrowned King because he played so hip, but nobody really wanted to realize that. You know, it was Dizzy Gillespie and all those cats, you know. The Uncrowned King, Kenny Dorham, I loved the way he played. And I listened to him a lot when I was younger and tried to pick up his lines, and it was hard, you know. So this is Joe Henderson's classic Recordame. Thank you.
It's great to see you all after a little while. We haven't been to appear here at the LA Jazz Festival Institute for a couple of years, but we're really happy to be back. Thank you, Ken and Eric, for having us back here. We're gonna play today some of the charts that you probably know and that we played over the years and that people got to like, but also we brought some new material as well, which I'm gonna tell you a little bit later about it. But first we're gonna play an arrangement of Cherokee that I wrote some years ago that kind of helped us getting some notoriety around the scene, which got us 2 Grammy nominations for our first album. So here's Cherokee. Thank you. Jeff Driscoll. And Kai Palmer.
We're going to play a tune called Stellar, which is based on the chord changes of Stella by Starlight. And who shall we feature? You want to play? Whom else? Jeff Bunnell? Is that okay? All right. And how about Brian Williams on baritone saxophone? Okay. We haven't featured Brian Williams, and he gets very upset if we don't feature him. So. That's actually not true. Sometimes he comes up to me and he goes, I don't want to be featured at all. Just keep me out of this. But we're going to feature him tonight anyway. Brian Williams on the baritone saxophone. This is called Stellar. And it's a contrafact, which is a term used for a song that exists, and we're going to use the chord changes of it, but we're going to call it a different name. And that's so that I can sell it. Otherwise, it's a big copyright hassle. You can't copyright chord changes, but you can use the chord changes to call it something else. So this is called Stellar, and it's based on Stella by Starlight. But I shouldn't have said that because I could get sued at that point. So keep this covert. I know. Yeah. I love the music business. All right, it's called Stellar. Here we go. go, man.
Thank you, Ken. Hearing all that stuff that Ken was talking about, I'm kind of tired already. Good to see you all. I see some familiar faces and hope to see you for many years to come. So, our first piece is Rain Check. It's written by Billy Strayhorn, who was a co-writer with Duke Ellington on a lot of pieces and wrote quite a few important pieces of his own. This is one of them, Rain Check.
Thank you.
Kevin Sells. Noah Janik on trumpet. And the band, just in general. This tune will get everybody relaxed and ready for a nice, easygoing evening. It's a walking blues called Any Doodle Do. Thank you. Brian Williams on baritone sax. And Bruce Babag on alto sax.